Inotropic drugs are a class of medications that affect the force and contractility of the heart. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. When it comes to pharmacology and respiratory care, most people only think about the medications that are given to affect the lungs. The heart and cardiovascular system is often overlooked. However, it's important to remember that respiratory therapists are trained to provide care for patients with conditions of both the heart and lungs. That is because these two major organs work together to pump oxygenated blood to all of the cells and tissues within the body. Therefore, if a disease is inhibiting the functionality of the heart, it could inadvertently affect the lungs as well. All of that to emphasize the fact that cardiovascular drugs are an important class of medication to learn and understand. There are a few primary types, however, for this video, we're specifically focusing on inotropic agents, which also have two different types, positive and negative. Negative inotropic agents decrease the contractility of the heart. However, this class of drugs overlaps with antiarrhythmic agents, which is a topic that we've covered in a separate video here on our channel. For this one, we're going to focus on the positive inotropic agents. In comparison, positive inotropes works by increasing the force and contractility of the heart. They are often administered in patients for the treatment of congestive heart failure. They're also useful in conditions that cause low cardiac output, such as cardiogenic shock. Some examples of the most common types of positive inotropic agents include digitalis or digoxin. These are cardiac glycoside drugs that increase myocardial contractility, which again is beneficial in patients with conditions that cause a low cardiac output. They are also useful in treating atrial arrhythmias as well. Additionally, digoxin may be indicated for the treatment of fetal supraventricular tachycardia. And just a reminder, negative inotropic agents have the opposite effect and work by decreasing the force of cardiac contraction. Some other types of cardiovascular drugs to be familiar with include antiarrhythmic agents, vasodilators, anti-anginal drugs, and vasopressors, each of which are medications that we've discussed in other videos here on our channel. But again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.